Hello guys, welcome back to my favorite channel. Right now, I want to say about working with corrections requires assurance and discipline. Working with corrections requires assurance and discipline. The chance for profits are very high in products with a big swing size and volatility, such as in the S&P 500 index, the Nasdaq 100 index, the DAX 30 index, and the DJ Euro Stocks 50 index. Cash current size, such as the US dollar against the Japanese yen or the euro against the US dollar, also may present opportunities. But a big swing size in a product we want to trade is not enough. High volume is at least as important. If the volume in the product is too small, the slippage and commissions may make trading unprofitable. Before working with corrections, traders need to determine the swing size and corrections level that they want to work with. Only then can we determine whether a product has naturally big or small swings and has a high or low volatility. There is no perfect rule to determine these parameters because every product is different. But eyeballing daily historical data for about a 3-year period can provide a good indication. As a rule of thumb, a product should not have more than 15 to 20 peaks or valleys over a 12-month period. In the DJ Euro Stocks 50 index show in figure for 11 a swing size of 300 basic points is a good size to work with. In the S&P 500 index, a swing size of at least 80 ticks is needed. In the Japanese yen cash currency, a swing size of 180 ticks is appropriate. Determining whether we are in an uptrend or a downtrend also can be a problem while working with corrections. The status of the market has to be addressed first. Otherwise, investors will never be able to decide in what directions to invest. As long as the market price continues to make new lows and the swing size is bigger than our predetermined swing size based on historical test runs, we will always sell the corrections level reaches 61%. If the market makes new highs, we receive buy signals whenever a trend correction of 61% occurs. But we will never know in advance whether we invest into a correction of an impulse wave in a downtrend. Into an impulse wave in an uptrend, only future price movements can answer these questions. To deal with this problem, we recommended working with bigger swing size and corrections levels. Although we may anticipate the directions of the next impulse wave incorrectly, our risk remains low and we can liquidate positions with a small loss if we are on the wrong side of the trend directions. Every time investors choose to enter a market according to a pattern of corrections to initial impulse wave, they must make sure that the entry is realized by the time of the corrections. A reliable way to manage being on time, or at least close enough for the corrections, is to combine swing size and corrections level with a confining entry rule. Generally speaking, a strong first impulse wave is followed by a strong corrections. The second impulse wave should be bigger than the first impulse wave. Therefore, a more sensitive entry rule can be used. Different entry rules in relation to swing size are shown in Figure 4.12. Many successful combinations of swing size, retracements, and entry rules are possible. The sample constellations in Table 4.2 show the underlying general pattern in a productive way. There are many other workable combinations. Sample parameters for an investment in the S&P 500 index might look like this. The minimum initial swing size in the S&P 500 index is set to 18 basis points. No corrections is as big as 61%. We do not get a signal. We never try to catch up with a runaway market, no matter how strongly the S&P 500 index might start to move, unless we get another entry change that adheres to the rules of price corrections. When a correction reaches the level of 61%, we have to enter long on the buy side at the previous day's high, or short on the sell side at the low of the previous day. After we are invested, we work with a profit target of 0.618 times the total swing size of the first impulse wave. We work with a trailing stop that is set at the lowest low of the previous 4 days. Our stop loss level is defined at the low of the starting day of the initial impulse wave. We do not follow a Rinty rule. If we get stopped out, we wait for a full new swing high or low based on the minimum swing size. Only then do we start looking for a new trading opportunities. Trading signals, all of the buy and sell signals that are presented in these sections are based on calculations from daily bar charts. At the end of this chapter, we provide readers with years of computer test runs of various products. We use three examples: the S&P 500 index, the DJ Euro Stoxx 50 index, and the Japanese yen in the cash currency market to explain valid strategies for making money through price corrections. We remind readers, however, that these illustrations are purely for educational purpose and are not recommendations for specific trades. The book's CD-ROM enables every investor to generate the same results that are shown here because the sample data sets we used are included with the software. Based on the preceding set of parameters for swing size from highs to lows and lows to highs, retracement, entry rule, profit target, trailing stop and stop loss rule, 9 sample trading signals can be generated for the S&P 500 index from January to November 2000. Figure 430 shows the relevant entry and exit points for the trading simulations in the S&P 500 index. It consists of 9 entry signals, profits, targets, and trailing stops. A stop loss exit applies only once on the very first trade. The strategy looks quite impressive. The year 2000 was favorable for trading corrections. Table 4.3 shows the breakdown of the different signals for a strategy that released on the corrections. The table consists of the 9 trading signals in the S&P 500 index with the respective high end figure 4.13 S&P 500 chart from 1.0 to 12.0. Simulation of trading signals based on corrections daily. Low reference from the chart entry rules, exit rules, and profit or loss per positions. To illustrate the applications of price corrections with a second data sample, we conducted a similar simulations of trading signals on the Japanese yen cash currency. The basic underlying parameters for this analysis are minimum swing size of 1.18 Japanese yen, retracement of at least 61% entry rule at previous when they hike or low, no retry. Profit target at 18 times the size of the impulse swing. Trailing stop set to 4-day low on basi and 4-day hikes on sales. The applications of these parameters to the daily bar chart of the Japanese yen cash currency results in a set of sample signals comparable to the ones in the S&P 500 index. By similarly analyzing the Japanese yen's cash currency, we can prove that the strong gains in the S&P 500 index were not accidental. The 9 sample trades in the Japanese yen cash currency have been profitable overall. 6 trades ended up in wins, and only 3 trades were losing trades. Profits totaled almost 9 points, which is a promising result for 11 months of sample calculations. To interpret the results properly when trading the Japanese yen against the US dollar, Readers must keep in mind that falling price indicate a stronger Japanese yen and rising prices indicates a stronger US dollar. Buy signals in our calculations 3-4 refer to a speculations on rising prices, which means a stronger US dollar and a weaker Japanese yen. Sell signals refer to an opposite speculations on a stronger Japanese yen and a weak US dollar. Thus, we buy and sell US dollars with reference to the Japanese yen as the best value for our calculations of profits or losses. Figure 4.14. Japanese yen chart from 1 to 11 simulations of trading signals based on corrections daily. The peak value references, as well as the profits and losses for the signals in the Japanese yen cash currency against the US dollar, are summarized trade by trade in table. The results in the S&P 500 index and the Japanese yen cash currency are very promising. However, it is a serious mistake to overestimate the strong gains accumulated with the profitable strategy of combining corrections with parameters for swing size, entry rule, stop loss rule, and profit target. During this sample's limited time span of 11 months, market conditions happened to favor the strategy of investing intra-corrective webs in the index futures and cash currency markets. Extended example, the problem with every test run is the time period tested. To show a product of the most recent 12 months, we have selected the DJ Euro Stoxx 50 index from August 2001 to August 2002. The 1 year period from 9/2001 to mid-2002 is interesting because it includes uptrends, downtrends, and sideways market patterns. The more we trace up moves and down moves mixed with sideways periods, the more reliable our trading strategy will become in the results of a simulation profitable. The following parameters are used for the DJ Euro Stoxx 50 index simulations. Our corrections level is 61%. The minimum swing size is 300 basic points. As an entry rule, we choose the previous 1 day high or low. In case of false breakouts, we work with 2 day highs or 2 day lows. As a trailing stop, we work with a 3 day penetration. After a buy signal, the stop loss is below the low of the previous impulse wave based on a daily close. Figure 4.15 shows a chart with 15 trading signals. To make it easier to follow the chart, the same signals are summarized trade by trade in table. Summary price corrections are important and profitable Fibonacci related trading tools as long as investors handle them properly. The following considerations are essential when working with price corrections. Consistency in the strategy, different swing size and volatilities for different products, magnitude of the first impulse wave from which the corrections level is measured, strength of the market trend, data compressions, weekly, daily, or intraday data, table 4, 5, trading signals, profit or lose in entry rule at exit rule at points 1, buy long, 3, 4, 195, sell flat, 3, 574, 79, 2, buy long, 3, 678, sell flat, 3,729,51, 3 by long, 3,671, sell reverse, 3,819,148 for sell reverse 3,890 by reverse 3,624,195 5 by reverse 3,624 sell reverse 3,797,173. Even more important is that corrections can be computer programmed and tested on historical price data. This makes it easier for traders to analyze different products at the same time to achieve better diversification. To conclude this section, we present some test results on a variety of stocks, one stock index future and one cash currency. Price extensions are volatile pricey movements that result from runway markets. Usually, price extensions occur when unexpected news reverses the trend direction. This discussions of price extensions is subdivided into two parts. Pricey extensions in 3-wave patterns and pricey extensions in 5-wave patterns. Pricey extension in 3-wave pattern extensions take place primarily in the third wave of a 3-wave pricey pattern. In an uptrend, the corrections does not go lower than the bottom of wave 1, whereas in extensions out of a bull trap or bear trap, formations of irregular tops or bottoms, the corrections can go higher than the height of the first impulse wave or lower than the low of the first impulse wave, respectively. Until here first for today, see you in the next video. Bye bye bye.